I'm Wade Wingler with the Endata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads. If you're using JAWS and Windows 10, there's something you need to know about using the internet. Belva Smith is going to show us a trick. Check this out.
Hi, welcome to today's tech tip. It's going to be kind of short and sweet. It's for those JAWS users who have either bought a new computer or decided to be brave and upgrade to Windows 10. Hopefully you're using JAWS 16 as you need to be for it to work with Windows 10. By now you have figured out that the new web browser called Edge is not compatible yet with your screen reader, so you need to still be able to use Internet Explorer 11. And you're probably wondering, well, where is it at? I can't find it. All I can find is Edge. So I'm going to show you how to find Internet Explorer in Windows 10, and then I'm going to show you how to set Internet Explorer to be your default browser so that you won't be bumping into Edge. You won't actually be removing Edge. It'll still be there. And when the two start to work together, you can begin to use it. But until then, you'll be able to flawlessly surf the web and do your web applications without running into Edge. So I think Nicole's going to position onto the screen now, and we'll take a look at what I'm going to do to get you there. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is press my Windows key. And on my laptop, that happens to be the third key from the left.
And type of text.
That opened up my search box. I'm going to type INT.
INT.
And that's going to bring up my Internet Explorer, although it didn't announce it.
Internet Explorer.
There we go. I up arrowed and down arrowed to get it to announce it to me just so I could make sure that I'm on Internet Explorer. So I'm going to go ahead and press enter. And there's my
Internet Explorer.
There's my familiar Internet Explorer. And as I said, I can go ahead and do my navigation just like I would in previous versions. Now, if I don't set this as my default, then what's going to happen is anytime I try to do any kind of a web application, it's going to go ahead and open up Edge, which, again, I'm not able to use that yet. So I'm going to go ahead and do an Alt F4 and close this. And
Internet Explorer dialog. Enter.
And what I've done to make it simple, too, when I do my Windows key and type IN. On the Internet Explorer, I've pressed the application key and then down arrow to pin to start menu. Right now mine says unpin because I've already done that, but that just makes it easier for me to find. So that's another little tip there too. So now to set that as my default, again, I'm going to press my Windows key and type default. And
default programs.
There's my default programs. I'm going to go ahead and press enter on that.
File Explorer control panel home link.
And I'm going to tab over to set my default programs.
Tab programs and features link. Tab. Tab. Set your default programs link.
And I'm going to press enter on that.
Enter. Set default programs.
And this is going to load all of the programs that are set to be my default. And I'm afraid we're going to see that when we get there, mine's already going to say Internet Explorer for web browsing because I've already made that change. But if I had not, then this is where I would do it. So let's see here.
Tab, list view, not selected, 3D builder, one of 3D build, contact support.
I'm looking.
Internet Explorer.
Now, if I had not already chosen Internet Explorer, that would have said Microsoft Edge. And I'm sorry, I probably shouldn't have done that before. But it would have said Microsoft Edge, and then I would have down arrowed to Internet Explorer, and then tab over to
tab, program description, read only, Internet tab, set this program as default button to activate, press spacebar, Alt plus S.
And on that, set this program as default, I could press the spacebar or do an Alt S, which I can go ahead and do since I didn't really make any changes. And that's it. So now, anytime I try to do anything on the internet, I will still be using Internet Explorer. And as I said, I didn't remove Edge, it's still there. So if at some time in the near future we can use it with our screen reader, then all I would have to do is press my Windows key, type in Edge, and begin using it, and then go ahead and set it as my default later if that's what I choose to do. So that's our tech tip for today.
So at least for now, that's the way you need to set up your computer so that you can use JAWS and Windows 10. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Endata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.